Video Vibe is brought to you in part by the Water and Sewage Authority. Water, use what you need. KFC, it's finger licking good. The Environmental Management Authority of Trinidad and Tobago, iCare TT program.
So last week on Video Vibe, we had a shake up at the number one spot and we gave voice to you, the viewer, with your comments from YouTube. This week we are shaking it up even more because we are now giving you a countdown that is 100% based on your votes. And to make things even more interesting, because it's a soca countdown, why not have a soca superstar on set with us? And so, none other than GBM Nuton.
Yep.
Whatever. GBM Nuton will be joining me for the entire session. So, it's all happening inside Video Vibe, your top 10 music countdown, part of your best carnival ever.
I'm in a tropical paradise I call home. It's like an alpha and omega, Trinidad to Vega. When I see my people dancing, all I hear is soca.
So GBM is a household name, but some people may not know what the abbreviation stands for. And since your experience, you might have given it some new meaning. Great bubbling man. What does it really mean?
It really means Great Brooklyn Movement.
Right.
Around the logo, you have those words. Mm-hmm. And I think the deeper meaning is just simply a group of people that come together and we moving forward as a family. You know what I mean? We production company, we getting into different types of production. So just a movement. Great Brooklyn Movement.
Now that production, getting into other types of music and production, that is, mm-hmm. is going to be something we'll get into later on in the countdown. But I do need to explain first that this time around uh-huh. is a little different. Normally we talk to the cut list, we check out the iTunes mm-hmm. and a bunch of things to create the list. This week it's purely on votes. So that's everybody going on to the site, choosing the top 10 favorites, and selecting videos.
Okay.
So we'll see how it goes, but so far so good, yeah?
Yeah.
All right. Jumping straight into the first video of the countdown, it's actually coming out from an artist who, well, she gives you some advice, kind of like you do, and she calls herself the Queen of Bacchanal. So the advice can go either way. Dasha Garcia is bringing in the first video on the countdown, but can you guess what it is? Any clues?
No, I can't. But any Dasha video I want to see.
Alright, fine. Yeah, fine, Dasha. You see a GBM and Dasha collaboration coming up?
It's been done before.
Again, why not? Videos?
Maybe.
Are what we want. It's Dasha with those study people at number 10. Yeah, can't study people videos playing. Mm-hmm. We watching it, we jamming.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You're feeling Dasha, new black and white stripes.
You can't dictate my pace like the old people. You can't study people who go help you when you're back against the wall. You can't study people who go pick you up in case you fall. If they don't like you, then you're doing something right. Just keep on doing it, doing it. Let them respect you for spite. Well, them drag my name on the ground and I wind back up and I keep it moving. What are you bad, are you good, are you in between? There's the same problem. As soon as I put on my clothes and step, step, them can't be me, them vex, vex. As I reach in the fet and start to get on them,
respect you for spite. They don't even know you, but they're just walking wrong.
Is to not study people. I think that's good advice, yeah. Mm-hmm. And you telling people practice, so you see we're going with the advice thing. I mean, don't know who's to follow, but
it ties in.
It does, right?
Yeah.
I think though that Dasha is pretty straightforward in her meaning. I was told you always go a little bit deeper.
Well, yeah, you know, the concept of practice is practice makes perfect.
Right.
With the music video, we wanted to do something a little bit fun and unexpected. You know, yes, the lyrics of the song are pretty straightforward,
right?
But the whole concept of practice is bigger than the song, right? Mm-hmm. And it's basically like whatever it is you're into, whatever it is you're working at, whatever it is you're practicing, basically, you know, practice is a repetition kind of thing. So it's like whatever that may be, you know, go hard at it. The video tells a story basically of somebody, you know, going through anxiety and nerves, I mean,
right,
and coming out of it, you know, on top in a fun way.
Definitely, on top of the bottom, because I mean, somebody thinks we might just see in that one. Well, actually, we'll let it be as you said. For now though, this next video is, well, pretty inspirational, if I may say so myself. It's actually you coming up with the next number, so tell me what they're actually going to see, Jimin.
So this is video number 9, yours truly GBM Nuton with practice.
GBM! Bend over, practice, for the work, gal brace, position, gymnast, love the way that you whine and jiggle it. Bend over, practice, for the work, gal brace, position, gymnast, in front the mirror, gal take a flick. Turn round, look back, take a pick. Whining skill, show them you have it. You master all of the tricks. Drop down flat and make your body split. Tick tock, tick tock, tick tock. How are you tick tock? Tick tock, tick. Wine to the bass. So keep whining your wine in your waist now. Bend over, practice for the work. Gal brace, position, gymnast. Love the way that you whine and jiggle it.
So much for coming out on top. She was real on the low. That was the plot twist of the countdown. Because here we are thinking, you know, she's working hard towards some really major serious goal.
But she is.
True. Maybe she is. Serious, but...
She's a serious mascot. Mm-hmm. She's serious about her splits and cartwheels. And...
In a shark suit. Baby shark suit. Yeah. That's all right. That immediately came to my mind too.
Because the sharks. Fun, it was actually it was a real fun shoot because I think a lot of people, you know, would have wanted to see a little more bubbling or a little more whining and that type of thing. But you know, we had the opportunity to kind of expand on the concept in our way,
right.
And we just felt like the mascot trick was it, because you know sometimes when you're going into practice and thing is like you're putting on a suit. When it's time to execute now, when you reach that point of execution, it's like you go into a different character.
Yeah, you're right.
Sometimes to bring out that, you know, that passion. So
That is pretty deep, actually. Have you ever found yourself in a situation where you needed to meet anybody other than Jason?
I think with every challenge, I'm not so much worried about like playing somebody else, mm-hmm. but I try to figure out, well, okay, who is Jason Carter? And I try to play the best version of him. So every night I go on stage,
that's why we get the bubbling version this last time. Before that,
you can't let what is bubbling.
I'll never. I wasn't prepared. Think about it. We went from, you know, Visitor to the Road and Calypso and now I'm bubbling tune. So I didn't get to see that side of you before.
Well,
I appreciate it though.
I've been practicing.
I see what you did there. On that note though, I might do a little practicing between the break. Mm-hmm. No, I will not be practicing with him in any way. I don't want to get in trouble, neither do I. You guys will be back after this.
I know. This country's sweet, I know.
So welcome back, you guys. We are joined on set by GBM Nuton all show long, and we were talking about videos that, you know, well, have similar messages. Mm-hmm. This next one has a pretty profound message as well.
For sure.
It is none other than
Patrice Roberts.
And in this video, she actually took shots of Trinidad and Tobago in ways that we may not necessarily appreciate, because you know, we hear all the time, we don't see it. Mm-hmm. As somebody who spends a lot of time abroad, you're back and forth, does this make you feel any certain type of way? Does it make you nostalgic even?
I just love the scenery of Trinidad and Tobago. I mean, you know, being out in New York, you don't see mountains in the background.
Definitely don't.
So definitely appreciate this video from Patrice, and definitely appreciate the message behind the song as well.
So much so that Patrice got herself recognition from one of our...
Big up, Patsy! At number 8, we have Patrice Roberts with This Is The Place.
This country's sweet, I know. Patrice again. I know. I love the greatest show. I know. Where can you find a curry pot over tree stone? It's big lime by the river. I know. We don't divide. In the morning we quarreling, in the evening we all liming together. I know. Like when the steel band and rhythm section play with that sweetness, you don't want to stay. I hammock under a mango tree. Go take all your stress away. So come here, we go jam, come jam in my island. Pick your destination, understand that this is the place to go. Come jam up on somebody, woman, you don't know. This is the place to go. Come free up your mind and let go to Calypso. This is the place to go. It's better new until tomorrow. Back and on this drum, I'll be tempo. Want to see the greatest festival in this world. This is the place to go. I know. This is the place to go. Beautiful masqueraders parade in the streets, ready to party. I know. It's part of we life. As we wake up, it's straight till the night. Plenty vibes in the city. I know. Like when the steel band and rhythm section play with that sweetness, you don't want to stay. A hammock under a mango tree. Go take all your stress away. So come here, we go jam, come jam in my island. Your destination, understand that this is the place to go. Come jump up on somebody, woman, you don't know. This is the place to go. Come free up your mind and let go to God.
I know. Like when it's still band and rhythm section, play with that sweetness, you don't want to stay. A hammock under a mango tree, go take all your stress away. So come here, we go jam, come jam in my island. Pick your destination, understand that this is the place to go. Come jam up on somebody, woman, you don't know. This is the place to go. Come free up your mind and let go to Calypso. This is the place to go. It's better than you until tomorrow. Back and on this drum on the tempo. Want to see the greatest festival in this world. This is the place to go. I know. This is the place to go. I know. This is the place to go. This is the place to go. I know.
Seeing some of those visuals must make you miss home a little bit.
Well, lucky for me, I'm here now. But definitely appreciate the effort on Patrice's behalf, the directors, all who involved with the video, because right. The imagery and, you know, everything that the song represents is definitely stuff that, you know, people who travel back and forth think about often.
I guess that's how you stay connected to your Trini roots then, yeah?
True soca. Basically, of course, like, you know, I want to kind of stay current with what's going on down in here, and it's like the music is definitely a part of, like, you know, current events, the sounds, what people listening to, what the different artists or producers might be, you know, cooking up. So definitely a way to connect.
Well, you connected in many ways though, because you write, you perform, and you produce, much like our next video contender. Here at number 7 is Gour-Votor with Write for Somebody.
Personally, don't take it too personally. They used to laugh at me personally. Now look at me. Them couldn't see my struggle. Them couldn't feel my pain. Them wasn't there when my heart did fight with my brain at night knocking. Because I come from a housing scheme with a big dream, and a meal was always a million miles away. I couldn't have one every day. And every time that I feel into quit and just give it up, I used to go on my knees and beg and start to pray. Now it's safe to say, me not go make them kill me. I when I dance in the face like that, I'm whining in the waist like that. Say me not go make them kill me. I dance in the face like that, I'm whining in the waist like that. Oh, it's a blessing, man, it's a blessing. It's a blessing, yes, it's the best thing. I may not be right for you, but I'm right for somebody. It's a blessing, yes, it's the best thing. I may not be right for you, but I'm right for somebody.
So like I was saying, just like Erwin, you're that triple threat, except he actually did edit this video himself. I know you might dabble a little bit in that too, no?
Yeah, I know Erwin is like dabbling in directing and editing his stuff, big up to him. I think it's just a natural evolution for some artists to kind of mess with the video production as well as, like, you know, the song production. So I myself did a bit of editing for practice video.
Uh-huh.
Actually, a video that didn't make this countdown, but
yet
was shot and edited by myself, was Fuel by GBM Nuton.
Okay, so maybe you might see that one coming into the countdown.
Soon.
Who knows? We'll see, and we will be the judge of your video editing skills. But now, though, we're going to jump across to another music video that was actually shot in Miami during Miami Carnival season.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you've done a few carnivals yourself.
Yeah.
Anyone other than Trinidad, perhaps, in your top three?
I would definitely say I had a time at Jamaica Carnival.
Why that?
Yeah, I mean, why not? You know, they say that Jamaica have, like, after Trinidad, Jamaica have the best KFC after Trinidad.
Best KFC, that's the reason.
You know, one of the other reasons I mightn't be able to talk about on here, so.
Ooh.
Jamaica, Jamaica.
We'll go with that. And you'll tell them what's the number six video then.
Number six video, big up to my boy Shal Marshall. This is Party We Party We Party We Love. Number six.
Party, mash up, party done. Party lift up now. Party get on over. Party, mash up, party done. Party lift up now. Party get on over. And it's party we party.
Special treat this week. I am joined by my fantastic co-host GBM Nuton.
What up?
And we are giving you a countdown that is entirely based on your votes. Now, this next contender on the countdown is somebody who is putting forth music in an abundance.
Mm-hmm.
Not doing production like you do, but it does mean that you could probably end up working with
her. Oh, definitely. It's definitely something that I've thought about. I think that this next artist's song is a nice compliment to the GBM song if we do come up with something together.
Right,
so.
Right. Because that production thing is still happening somehow in that busy schedule, isn't it? Jesus. I pray for you and I'll send you vitamins. Coming up next is Nyla Blackman with I Am Love.
I am mine. Do the voice.
I am mine. Oh, he's sweeter than when he licked the pan. Jamayan, woman has leave their man. I am mine. Oh,
on the countdown, none other than Patrice Roberts, because we saw her first with This Is The Place, and now this next one actually shares something with you as well. She's got beautiful styling on this next visual, and you're a pretty stylish guy yourself. So maybe, just maybe, the next couple of videos we'll see a little bit more of that GBM swagger coming up.
Definitely. I think, like, we now getting into the video production,
right?
And we're definitely gonna embellish a little bit as we go down the road and get a little bit more adventurous and, you know, stylized. Never know where you might see popping up in a GBM video next.
GBM in a suit doesn't seem too far-fetched. I can see you decked out.
Oh, for sure, for sure.
When it's all far-fetched, I can't picture you, like, doing the super short pants, Carnival Monday look though. That doesn't, no. I'm good at this. I know it's not gonna happen. But up next is Patrice Roberts giving us I Like It Hot at number 4.
Come now, baby, rise it and
So that Patrice was a slower song, a more groovy vibe, something you're familiar with, and we actually credited you largely towards moving that even further back in 2017 when you would have given us much more groovy music.
Yeah.
That's a good vibe though. Good place to be or not?
Yeah, I mean, I will accept the flattery. I'll accept the flattery. Groovy is definitely like my pick. If I had to pick between groovy and power.
Really?
Yeah, I like groovy vibes.
Well, that is going to be in keeping with the road march conversations. Now, since there might be a slower road march than people are used to, how do you feel about that one?
I'm not sure why people might feel challenged by this conversation. We've had slower road march
in the past
songs before, so I don't have a problem with a slow road march song, because even though the tempo might be slow, the song itself, you know, there's that energy. To me, road march is, you know, having a song giving you that energy when you're crossing the stage.
Right.
You're feeling to, you know, explode on the stage, basically. Wave, whine, jump, whatever it may be.
Mm-hmm.
And I think this year, there is such a song that kind of creating this conversation
about
a slower road march.
And take it away.
So, speaking of that slower song, here's Kes at number 3 with Savannah Grass.
We'll take a break, and when we come back, we'll find out who's on top. Welcome back to Video Vibe, where we are joined by our special guest, GBM Nuton, and we're giving you a countdown that is 100% based on your votes. Now, before we continue in the countdown, though, I do want to ask, since we talked about soca mana, we talked about the fashion, we need to talk about what else we're going to see from GBM, because you have a lot going on.
Yeah, we do. 2019 is definitely going to be like an eventful year for myself and the camp. Straight out of Carnival, April 6th, we have the GBM showcase in New York City.
Yeah.
So, you know, right now, in the midst of Carnival, even though we're keeping up with the shows, all the interviews, the appearances, we're kind of like planning
for that,
from Trinidad. It's very difficult, but very fun.
And the same?
Yeah, because, you know, the challenge is on. And I think this year is our 10-year anniversary.
Right.
So we're really trying to do something that, you know, gives back to the 10 years of support that we received.
Now, a showcase is different from any other, well, forum, so to speak.
Yeah.
Because in that, you're going to have everybody within the family, and then...
then some. Yeah. Some of the artists that we worked with before.
Oh, nice.
Maybe some of the artists that we plan to work with moving forward. But, you know, those are surprises that you just have to kind of, like, you know, check us out and...
fine. No secrets.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll make a trip. Maybe I'll get him to see it. But other than the GBM showcase, your calendar for the year is planned out as well. Because you're going to have a carnival, they got a few things to do, yeah?
Yeah, for sure. There's definitely bookings happening.
Mm-hmm.
This year, I want to put out my second album. So there's going to be a lot of studio time as well. You know, a lot of traveling and studio.
Yeah.
But it's going to be good.
Hopefully in between there you can put in a little video or two so we can see you on the countdown again.
Definitely. Mm-hmm. Because with the albums comes me wanting to, you know, visually, like, it's a creative thing, you know, when I get into the studio and I get into album mode. Mm-hmm. And getting into that mode now with some videography under my belt is like, I'm encouraged to, you know, add visuals to a lot of the songs and, you know, maybe just some random stuff in between there, showcasing maybe something new that I learned editing wise. But I think this year is going to be like
the year of
GBM. The year. The best year.
I like that. I like that a lot.
The best year for GBM, trust.
All right, I hold you to it. In between that, though, we will check in for more songs, more releases, and we'll try to keep up with your tour schedule as well. For now, though, one last question on the GBM tip that is getting into your business a little bit.
Shoot.
How would you, or rather, if you were to give any advice to somebody who's trying to wear all those hats, mm-hmm. writer, producer, videographer, everything in between that you might learn, any tips?
Stay focused. Definitely, you know, stay disciplined, because mm-hmm. I believe that all success is through discipline at some point. And stay motivated, you know, keep yourself, you're going to have challenging times. And, you know, I think the challenging times are there to motivate you into achieving your goal, proving to yourself that mm-hmm. this is what you really, really want. So just go at it full force and don't give up.
Getting back into the countdown, this next video is one of two songs that is really, really big on the people I heard them actually.
Oh yeah, for sure, for sure. This is Farmanapi at number two with Hooking Me. If you want me to go,
you can't be looking the way you do. I had to go down on the octave too much.
I don't know what to do, so I'm pleading. Plus you ain't giving me no reason. You tell me this is the end of the season. Mash up everything, dress so. But you don't understand when you watch me. I said I see that I win the lottery. How you go pick up dress so and then dump me? No, baby, no. But you pack on me clothes in a garbage bag. You put it on the ground by the roadside. You tell me get out your place to come inside. Baby, don't do me that. You go break me. What I say you are hearing. You say the love disappearing. On my drawer and cupboard you're clearing. Mash up we think dress so. When I met you Marshall tell me
hey, ah! That is a trophy.
So if you throw away the thing it go hurt me. No baby no. But you pack on my clothes in a garbage bag. You put it on the ground by the roadside. You tell me get out your place to come inside.
Like a man who's ever had his clothes in a garbage bag, man.
Nah.
He ever helped your friend to have his clothes in a garbage bag?
Nah.
I don't know. But, I mean, Nappy was a different situation. His story is literally a continuation.
Yeah.
Most of his videos, most of his songs continue from one point to the other throughout his relationship. And when we may not get into your relationship, but we could get into what you practice a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Since you're giving everybody advice, let's play a little game. Name one sport that you really had to practice plenty because you're real bad.
Football.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'm not good at football.
And this is the thing, I always wanted to be like a footballer. Like when I was younger, I thought I was Marvin Foster, number 10.
Oh, look at you.
So.
Now he's gonna
like,
okay.
Yeah, but my skills wasn't anywhere close.
It's more like, you know, a cricketer trying to play football. That's all right. You know, everything is for everybody.
Yeah.
All right. In the case of the music business, then, you do so much within it. Mm-hmm. Have you ever found any difficulty in one aspect that you had to practice more than others?
Yeah. I think transitioning from a producer songwriter mm-hmm. to an artist is a challenge because, you know, an artist is a whole completely different entity by itself. Mm-hmm. There's many different things to consider, like, you know, there's the image, there's the skills, the ability to sing or dance, performing, period.
Yeah.
And then, you know, for me, there's the message behind the artist, you know, like, is it going to be a commercial style artist or is it a rootsy or, mm-hmm. you know, it is I had a lot of difficulty, like, basically finding my my little niche as an artist. And eventually I just kind of decided, you know, with being myself.
Oh, was a good choice.
And the challenge in that, yes, you know, a lot of people would encourage you, you know, artists being themselves, or creative being themselves. But the challenge in that is, like, you also have to find ways to, you know, there might be some things about you that people are not accustomed to, and you have to find ways to, you know, bring it across in a way that, you know, still entertains. And, you know, if you're, my aim is love and fun, is like, I want people to have a good time. So I have to still find ways to bring that across. You know, not everybody will understand my kind of fun.
That's a valid point, but you're doing a good job so far.
Thank you.
Granted, though, that I did make you up for not being able to play football, what was one thing you didn't have to practice a lot?
Art.
Oh,
drawing.
Okay.
Came natural.
So yeah. Portraits aren't like beginning from GBM.
Yeah. Sick with the pen or the brush.
In many ways, because you're
charcoal.
Right too. Oh, oh. All these mediums? Keep form, see?
Yeah.
All right, cool. So on that note, we return to the countdown, and before we give you the number one video, let's do a quick recap of what we've seen so far.
Party, mash up party, don't party, lift up, no party, get turned over.
So the number two song on the Purple Arch Rhythm and the number one song on it too. That means that the rhythm is actually doing pretty well. So as a producer, slash writer, slash everything else, why do you think that is though?
Those two songs in particular, I think they're really well written. I think the topics that the songs portraying are extremely relatable as well. So particularly the number one song is written in our lingo.
That's right.
You know, it's like it's a full-on conversation. So that, as well as, you know, excellent production, I would say, because yeah, I think the production, if you really listen to the music behind it, is really give you, you know, a real happy feeling, a nice euphoric feeling. So I mean, the people voted for it, and these two songs, number two and number one on the countdown, they are very popular throughout the carnival. So. Mm-hmm.
So you probably know who we're talking about by now. This being her first time at the number one spot, it is officially your number one since you guys voted for it. GBM, tell them who it is.
This is number one, Nadia Batson with So Long.
When last did it talk to you? So long I ain't talked to you. Go friend from long, long time. Let we just take a wine. I wanna hold on together and rock away the whole night. And I'm glad to see you, my friend from long ago. Don't even want to go. I wanna hold on together and rock away the whole night.
So long, I see you. Give me a wine now. Give me a wine now. Give me the wine that I want long time. Now.
Long, long time. Long, long
so
time.
So long, I see you. Give me a wine now. Give me a wine now. And I will make up for all this time. I'll make up for all this time, Lord.
GBM, thank you so much for joining me. It was fun.
Yeah, definitely.
Maybe we'll see you on the screen again.
Maybe.
But also, let me remind you guys that you need to keep voting because we have just one episode left. So head over to ttt.live/vote to vote for your favorite music videos to make it to next week's countdown. So who are you going to be on the road with Carnival Monday and Tuesday?
I'm definitely going to be on the road with Yuma this year. Right. Yeah, I'm pumping with the Yuma posse.
Fair enough.
I think it's gonna be a real lit one.
Yeah. You're on your truck, you're in the road.
All over.
Okay, it is a real authentic carnival, is it?
Mm-hmm, for sure.
Enjoy yourself. And on that note, guys, I gotta say goodbye. Till the next episode, you guys. Remember, it's all part of your best carnival ever.
Bend over, hey. Practice, footy work, gathering. Position, gymnast,
love
the way that
you're
winding. I got it.
I don't
know. Until then. So long, I see you. Give me a wine now. Give me a wine now. Give me the wine that I want. Long time.
Long, long time. Long, long time.
So long, I see you. Give me a wine now. Give me a wine now. And I will make up for all this time. I'll make up for all this time. Love.
It was just last week when I called your name. I did ask your friend and them. When last did they talk to you? So long I ain't talked to you. Go funny, you're in my side.
Video Vibe was brought to you in part by the Water and Sewage Authority. Water, use what you need. KFC, it's finger licking good. The Environmental Management Authority of Trinidad and Tobago, iCare TT Program.